Hi guys, the season of competition is over and now it's autumn and soon we'll have winter in Russia, but it's not the reason to stop training and to stop experiments. That is why now I'm going to have some interesting tests. I'll compare Russian slugs, Russian heavy slugs and foreign slugs. Thanks to H&N Sports, they give me the opportunity to test their new slugs. Those are of 0.217 and 0.218 caliber. The weight is 27 grains. These are very light slugs if to compare them with Russian slugs. I'll make my this video in my usual style, picture in picture. So in one picture, you'll see me, and the second picture will show you the Labrador settings so that no one could have any questions. After that I'll make a comparison table and we'll see the ballistic coefficient of these slugs. In the second part of this video I'll go to my shooting range, semi-open shooting range, and compare the accuracy of these slugs. And I hope the results will be very interesting. Let's go! Guys, let's start with the heaviest slug I have. It's experimental Russian slug. Me and my friend developed it. It has extremely high ballistic coefficient. Its weight is 2.6 grams. It's 40 grains. And this air gun is adjusted to the speed of 270 meters per second at average speed. We'll make 30 shots to have enough volume of statistics to analyze the ballistics of this slug. I'd like to introduce you the newest ballistic software from Russia. It was made with consultation of the best shooters, of the best military people, of the best snipers. It will allow you, using Labrador, to measure the exact ballistic coefficient of your pellets, slugs, or firearms, bullets, or anything you want. It doesn't matter. Here's what you have to do. First of all, you've got to put in all the weather conditions, its temperature, air pressure, humidity, and the height above the sea level. And after that, you just put all the information you've got from the Labrador to the special chart. After you've done it, you can calculate the BC, ballistic coefficient, and this software will give you the very exact ballistic coefficient of your projectile. So I like it very much. It saves a lot of time and it allows me to make very exact calculation and to shoot very, very well. I think that it's one of the reasons how I won American Field Target matches at Extreme Bench Rest. I've used this software to know all my corrections to the distances. The next slug we're going to test is one of the most popular in Russia mass-produced airgun slug. It's called Katyusha. It has the weight of 2.4 grams and it is very widely spread in Russia. And this slug took many prizes and very good shooters shoot with it. I used to shoot with it before, but now I'm shooting 40 grain slugs because they have left less wind drift. Let's try and test it.
which in turn support slugs. Those are new slugs just for testing these ones. They have original shape, their hollow point, and they are very light. So I think the speed will be about 300 meters per second. Let's check it. So guys, that's the last experiment for today. I'll compare classic 22LR ammo. It looks like that. And to compare the ballistics between Russian heavy slugs and slugs in general and this ammo. Well, let's call it a day. I finished testing the ballistics of all slugs. I've got to make all the calculations to find out the ballistic coefficient of every slug. Now, we should use RA4 and drag function for this kind of ammunition. And I think that we'll have very interesting results.
Well, as you can see, very interesting results showed Molodoy number 4. It's our experimental slug. It has extremely high ballistic coefficient. Now I'll show you the shooting, the accuracy shooting at my semi-close shooting range. We'll start with that very slug number 4, experimental one, with a very, very high ballistic coefficient. And this air gun was adjusted just to shoot these various slugs and other slugs with a weight of 40 grains. We'll start with 225 bar pressure every time. This air gun is not regulated to get the best results we can. As you can see, this slug and this air gun is really accurate. I like it very much. The next slug we are going to shoot is the 37 grain Russian Katyusha slug. This air gun is not adjusted for this very slug right now because it likes more speed, about 290 meters per second, and now it gives about 270 meters per second. But let's try it and see its accuracy. That is not that result that can satisfy me, but still we tried. And the last but not the least are H&N sports lugs. They're not heavy enough for my airgun, they give too much speed, but still we have to try them. Because my airgun is not regulated, we can wait till the air pressure goes low and the speed also goes lower and check the accuracy at these speeds. The speed is 299 meters per second and will go lower because we are the below main pressure of this air system.
Ничего себе.
Well, what I can say, this H&N slugs at the speed of 298 meters per second goes rather accurate, but I have to adjust the settings of my airgun for slugs. I'm not ready to do this because I'm gonna have trainings and a lot of practice during this winter with this airgun, and in my next video I'm gonna try these slugs and other H&N sport slugs on my Extreme Bench Rest air gun. It has less power and I'm sure that it will be very, very suitable for these projectiles. Thank you guys for watching this video. It's winter now, there's no any competition, so I'm gonna have a lot of interesting experiments with different slugs, pellets, air guns, and I'm gonna reach the very top accuracy to have the best results ever I can show the next year. Thank you and subscribe. Bye.